Good morning, children. Welcome back to our EVS class. In the last video, we were reading the chapter, The River's Tale. So, I'm again continuing with this chapter. The last question that was discussed in the video was, is the water from the sea drinkable or not? Why? So, water from the sea is not at all drinkable because they are salty. The salt is mixed in that water, so it is not able to drink. Do you think that there would be changes taking place in the river, pond and stream at different times of the year? What kind of changes would these be? Discuss. Yes, we all can discuss this point that earlier it was not very much polluted. The environment was really very pure because there was not so many vehicles running by. So the river water was really pure. By the time we were getting modern, by the time we were having technologies, by the time we were getting the vehicles, the transport system were getting improving day by day. So we are having the diesel, the petrol, the smoke is there in the environment. So they are very much, the industries are taking place and the drainage water is coming inside the river, pool, pond and everywhere. So they are harming the water bodies. So this way the water of today is not at all pure to drink. So the next question, will there be the same amount of water in the ponds or river during the rainy season and in summer? So this is a very quick answer. You all can answer. In the summers, though it is very hot, very humid, and the sun is hotter and hotter, so the water is very less in the streams and in this season. And during rainy season, though we have lots and lots of rain, so the rivers will get full of water. Now, here is a question for you all. Is there a pond, river or lake near your town or city? Find out. Now, here a few questions are here. This is a kind of homework you all have to fill. Are there any changes in the water? For example, is there a pond, river or lake near your town or city? So, for example, I am giving you the answer as we are all in the city of Lucknow. So, we have the river running by is Gomti. So, you will write about Gomti, what kind of water you have a chance to see in the Gomti. So, what the color you can see, what are the kinds of birds. So, you all can, this questions can be asked to your father. You can discuss if they are going to that side, to near the river side. So, you all can discuss it with your parents. And if you have a chance, you can write it here also. What happens when there is a flood? Now, here is a question. Have you ever seen or read about floods where? Now, flood is, what is a flood? First of all, you all must be knowing about flood, the excess of water. Jab pani bahut zyada ho jata hai aur gaon mein aur shehron mein chala aata hai, river mein apni bandh ke andar nahi hota hai pani, to use hum kehte hain ki baad aa gayi, yani ki flood situation. Pani apne se zyada ho gaya, excess ho gaya, because of heavy rain it can happen, because of few of the rivers also get merged in the river, because of some mountain rivers water flow in the river water of the coming area that is coming towards our city. So these are all the reason that the flood occur. So the next question, how would you know if the water is dirty? If the water looks clean, can you be sure that it is all right to drink that water? No, we cannot say, because the germs cannot be seen with the eyes also. There are very minute germs still present in the water. How does water become dirty? Now here is a very good question, ki pani kaise ganda hota hai? How does water becomes dirty? Yes, we can read this paragraph. You saw in the picture that as the river flowed, through or near many villages, towns and city, the water changes. जैसा कि आपने बेटा देखा कि in the picture or in the situation that has been given, the story of the tale, that the river water is coming from the mountain area to many towns, to many villages and the last to the cities. And as the moment goes by, the water changes its color. The people use the river water for many different things. पानी को लोग जो है वो अपनी तरह से use करते हैं for different such as washing, कोई कपड़े धुलता है, कोई उसमें नहाता है, कोई अपने जानवरों को नहलाता है, कोई बर्तनों को साफ करता है. Many of these activities made the water dirty. और ये सारी activities से पानी क्या हो जाता है, वो गंदा हो जाता है. The water in the river kept changing as it flows through various places. Water in ponds and lakes can also become dirty due to similar reason. Ponds और lake का भी पानी इन्हीं reasons की वजह से ख़राब हो जाता है या गंदा हो जाता है. From where do you get your drinking water? आप पानी कहाँ से पीते हैं? A river or a lake? Do you think that like the river in the picture, your river or lake can also be affected? Yes, of course, in our city also. For example, Gomti is very much affected. It is all full of water pollution. Many people we can see around, they were washing the clothes. Even the many of the buffaloes were also inside the water having a bath. And few more activities are going on. Many garbage is there around the river and the surroundings are not at all clean. Even the industrial water drainage is also going inside that river. So for this activity, this is an activity. For this activity, you will need to bring certain things from your home. You will find most of these in the kitchen. 5 to 6 glasses of water, then bottle, 5 to 6 glasses or bottles. Okay, chalo, I can discuss this activity with you all. We don't have a class, so let's discuss. Hame kya chahiye? 5 se 6 glass ya to bottles. And for that, next, salt, sugar, cooking soda, haldi, flour and dal. About half a teaspoon each, आधा teaspoon जो चाय का चम्मच होता है वो हमें चाहिए. कुछ नमक, कुछ शक्कर, कुछ कुकिंग सोडा, हल्दी, फ्लावर. Then next is lemon juice, soap water, शरबत oil, 1 spoonful each. ये सारी चीज़ें हमें पूरा एक चम्मच चाहिए. Then what to do? Fill about half of each bottle or glass with water. Now 6 glasses you are having, you can do it at home also, but don't spoil the things. Okay, ask your mama to give you few things to do this experiment. Okay, let's take the glass of water inside the bottles. About half of each bottle. चाहे तो हम glass ले लेते हैं या bottle ले लेते हैं और उसमें आधा आधा पानी भर लेते हैं. Make sure that all have the same amount of water. If you are taking 5 glasses, तो उसमें बराबर का पानी होना चाहिए. Now, one by one, put each of the things in water. For example, एक बार हम अगर glass में हल्दी डाल देते हैं आधा चम्मच in the first glass. Oil हम दूसरी glass में डाल देते हैं. Soda हम third one में डालते हैं. And until you have one thing in each glass. हर glass में कोई भी एक चीज़ हम डाल देते हैं. Mix each thing in the water and see what happens. अब हम हर चीज़ को डालने के बाद glasses में उसे खोलते हैं और देखते हैं कि क्या होता है. Write your observation in the table. Now here is the table. We have to write your observations. Sugar dissolved mixed in water. Did not dissolve in water. Color of the water changes. Color of the water does not changes. For example, sugar. I'm telling you, sugar dissolve in water. Yes, did not. You will put across. Color will not change. Color of the water does not change. Then, if you are putting haldi, haldi also get dissolved. Then, color of the water. Yes, of course, changes. Color of the water does not change. So this way you are going to write your observation in this chart. Now, on the basis of your observation, tell, do all the things dissolve in water? No. Does the color of the water always changes? No. Did oil dissolve in water? No. How can you say whether it has dissolved or not? Because we can see the oil particles on the surface of the water. It used to swim on the upper surface of the water. It never mingles. Imagine how it would be. Think like sugar, salt, lemon juice, sherbet, etc. Imagine how it would be if things like sugar, salt, lemon, juice, sherbet, etc. could not dissolve in water. अगर क्या होता कि sherbet dissolve नहीं होते, sugar नहीं dissolve होती, lemon juice नहीं, तो हम sherbet कैसे पीते? We were quite far away with this sweet, sweet dissolving watery things, this juices. Imagine how would you think like stones, chalk, plastic and garbage would dissolve in water. Oh my God, if they dissolve in water, what will happen? There are many things that dissolve easily in water. Some of these can be very harmful for our body. Hence, it is important that we clean water before drinking it. Yes, children, like in many of the houses, we are using the RO or the Purettes to get the pure water, because many things, many germs, many chemicals are now present inside the water. One of the best ways to do this to boil the water, and the first thing that has been given in your chapter, how to purify the water, is to boil it up. हमें हमेशा पानी को खोला कर या उबाल कर पी लेना चाहिए. But nowadays, तो every house, in our house, we are having the purifiers. So no need to boil that water. If for some reason अगर light चली जाती है या कोई problem होती है घर में, so in that case you can boil the water and then उसको ठंडा करने के बाद हम पी सकते हैं. If for some reason this cannot be done, you can you think for some other ways to clean water? So how many ways? I am sending you the answer. How is drinking water cleaned in your house? हमारे घर में कैसे clean होता है? With the purifiers. Find out the many different ways of cleaning water at home. Draw a picture showing any two ways of cleaning of water. So here is the chapter that need to discuss many things. We have discussed it also. I'm not going to send you any of the question and answer. In the next video, I'm sending you the book answers. Okay, children, you're not having your copy. So I'm sending you the PDF. I will send you the PDF in the next video. Though this video is only for the explanation, the river tales. What you have to do in this video, you need to cover up this chart on page number 111 that has been given. What did you observe? Put a tick mark in the right places. So this is all for this video. Enjoy your day. Be happy and be safe. Meet you in the next video.